Judith Durham and the Seekers not only helped put Australian music on the world stage, but they provided a long-lasting legacy for generations of music lovers. As we know, Judith passed away over the weekend at the age of 79. But in 2018, Craig Bennett had this very special interview with Judith Durham, looking back at her stellar career.
Long before INXS, Silverchair and the Divinyls, there was one Aussie band breaking records right around the globe.
The world loved us and, you know, it was never going to end. It was just an amazing success that nobody in a million years could have predicted.
It is, of course, the Seekers, made up of Athol Guy, Keith Potker, Bruce Woodley and the ever-radiant Judith Durham. They remain one of our greatest exports, dominating the charts around the world throughout the 60s. For Judith, joining the Seekers was destiny. It was day one of a new job when she met someone who would catapult her life from secretary to singing sensation.
When I walked into that office, the girls, when I told them I was a singer, they said, oh, there's somebody else here who sings, and it turns out that it was Athol Guy. And destiny took me in there. And that very evening, Athol said, come along, I work with Keith and Bruce. Why don't you come along and have a sing with us at this little coffee lounge? And that was Treble Clef, and that was the first time the Seekers as a sound ever sang. Yeah, and there I was, stuck there. You know, it's just, how can that happen?
And that was 1962.
I think it was. I lose track, but it must have been.
Judith was just 20 when Athol Guy used his contacts in the advertising industry to secure the Seekers a spot performing on a cruise ship from Australia to London.
And little did we know that we'd end up being offered, more work if we stayed in England. And then we made the big record, of course, I'll Never Find Another You, which made me a pop star.
So, Judith, how, with your 21st birthday looming,
yes,
and what was meant to be a 10-week trip now suddenly turning into who knows when, what did you say to your mum and dad back home?
Oh, I felt really awkward about it, you know. And to other people too, because I'd told other people that I was coming back and I had a couple of gigs lined up and stuff. I got on the phone to mum and dad, but that was a big deal to ring overseas on a trunk call. I mean, blimey, this is an expensive thing to do.
You mortgaged the house.
Just about, yes. But truly, and I had to tell them on this long trip, well, sorry, Mum, I'm not coming back. You know, so that was a big deal. For I know I'll never
find another you. In 1968, Judith shocked fans and her bandmates when she announced she was leaving the Seekers. For the
what all four of us had said, that if any one of us wanted to leave, we would give 6 months' notice.
So you had that pact?
Oh, well, that's what we'd said. So I assume the boys would have also thought of that.
So, Judith, how did Athol, Bruce and Keith cope with the bombshell you're about to drop?
Well, they didn't give me any indication that they weren't okay to go along with it. It was after a couple of years that I had the feeling that maybe, you know, they might have wished that it was a bit of a shock for them. Sometimes I
look out my window. In spite of her overwhelming talent, worldwide acclaim and countless accolades, Judith secretly suffered from crippling self-doubt.
I was full of conflict in that I felt I was too overweight. That was a big thing for me. I thought I would have to lose weight before I went over to England. So when we were offered the shipping line free trip, you know, I was making all my own clothes to try to disguise my weight and, you know, and trying not to eat too much. And it was really hard for me. And then, of course, suddenly to become a pop star and I had to dress myself and try and look slim and all those things. It was pinching myself, but it was this never feeling quite good enough to be given the amazing opportunities that we were given. So the boys, of course, the boys were amazing. They all looked gorgeous and, you know, and so musically talented and everything. And so for me, I always thought, well, they don't really need me. You know, it was a little bit like that. It was only years later that I realised my voice is something unique. Not that it's the best voice in the world, but there was something about it with the blend of the three boys' talents and mine that just gave the public something magic that they'd never... The sound of the Seekers was very, very unique. We were absolute pop superstars. So, you know, the penny didn't drop for me till about, you know, 10 years later or more, before I realised, oh my God, you know, there's Australia's first pop princess sort of thing, you know, international from that point of view. But I just feel the same as I ever did. I've just done a lot of things and sung a lot of things, of course. For the